Hey, what's up guys, it's Vimal here and welcome back to another video on my channel. So after a long time, I'll be doing something from the photography side. On my desk over here, I've got a brand new gimbal to show you all. So this is not just another ordinary gimbal guys, it's a special 3-axis gimbal made for DSLRs by Fiutech. The special thing about this product is, it's a monster load gimbal. The company calls it as monster load gimbal because this thing supports max payloads of up to 4000 grams, which is around 4 kgs. So you can even throw heavy cinema cameras like Canon C200, C300, as well as RED cameras, and yet this gimbal can handle them. Apart from that, it also has some special features like, I think this is the only gimbal in the market that comes with a special touchscreen on it guys. So using that touchscreen, you can completely control the gimbal and handle it. That is super awesome, right? And also, it also comes with some special features which I'll tell you in this video. So let's get started. So the Fiutech's AK4000 DSLR gimbal came in this sort of packaging. There is nothing written on the package except my name and the Fiu branding on the side. So let me just grab my knife, take the packaging and see what do we have on the inside. Alright, let's open it and check it out. On opening the box, we got a lot of stuff on the inside. And what's this? Looks like the company has also sent us some accessories along with the gimbal. Let me show you. Whoa guys, it's a dual handle grip for the AK4000. This is a very special accessory and is entirely made of carbon fiber. And below that, we've got the Fiutech's AK4000 flagship gimbal for DSLRs. Oh my god, it's a quite big box and definitely feels heavy in the hand. We've got a picture of the gimbal and says AK4000 on the front. Okay, I don't want to waste much time over here, so we'll quickly finish the unboxing part. On opening the box, we've got another case inside. It's a carry case for the gimbal entirely made of thermocol. And looks like the gimbal is inside that case. And along with that, you've also got some paperwork over here, which includes a quick start guide, a warranty card, and a user manual. Just make sure to read them for all the info on the product. Now let me show you the case. The AK4000 gimbal comes in this thermocol carry case. It's a decent case, lightweight, and easy to carry. But instead of thermocol, I felt the company should have at least gone with a plastic case, as it's a quite expensive gimbal. Anyways, let's continue with the unboxing. So finally, here it is guys, the Fiutech's AK4000 gimbal. And looks like we've got a lot of accessories in the box along with the gimbal. I'll show them to you one by one. Let me first take the gimbal out of the box. So this is how the AK4000 3-axis DSLR gimbal looks like. The company calls it as a monster load gimbal because it supports an insanely high max payload of about 4 kgs and also has a smart LCD touchscreen panel on the front, using which you can seamlessly control the gimbal. The gimbal definitely feels solid in the hand, it's entirely made of metal and weighs around 1.43 kgs. So before we check it out in detail, let me also show you the other stuff we got in the package. You get a special carbon fiber handle extension rod. This thing is literally made out of carbon fiber and is super strong and lightweight. Love the pattern all over it. It's got a 1/4-inch thread at the top and the bottom, so you can easily attach it to the gimbal's handle and increase the overall length. Along with that, you also get a mini tripod for the gimbal. It's a high quality tripod entirely made of metal and has a 1/4-inch thread at the top. There's also a Manfrotto standard quick release plate, 4 18650 batteries each of 2200 mAh capacity, you get them free in the box, a 4-in-1 18650 battery charger, a lot of cables to connect different cameras, a regular micro USB cable, extension rod and a packet of screws. So that's it, these are all the items we got in the AK4000 package. Now let me also unbox this dual handle grip for the gimbal and show you the accessory. So this is how the inside looks like. As I've told you earlier, the AK4000 is a modular gimbal. That means it can easily be disassembled and joined with this to create an ultimate carbon fiber video rig stabilizer cage for your camera. So this is how the handle looks like. They're entirely made of carbon fiber and feel very lightweight in the hand. You get a lot of attachment in the kit. There's an upper handle, lower handle, and left extension rod. For the right one, you need to use the gimbal's handle itself. All these parts join together to create an ultimate dual handle cage for your camera. So that's it, we're finally done with the unboxing. And these were all the items we got in the package. We got a lot of accessories in the box. So now what I'll do is I'll just fix my camera on the gimbal and give you guys a closer look. Alright, so that was our unboxing of the Fiutech's AK4000 gimbal. Now let me just give you an overview on the product and also talk about the build quality. So as you can see, guys, I've already fixed my camera on it. This is my Sony's A6500, and I've also balanced the gimbal. Balancing this gimbal is very easy. I've already shown you guys a balancing procedure in a lot of my old gimbal videos. I'll just leave a link to that in the card above. You can check it out there for balancing procedure. Okay, talking about the design, it's got a very ergonomic design and feels very comfortable when you hold it. The gimbal weighs around 1.45 kgs, guys, so it's definitely a bit heavy, but no worries, once you start using it, you'll get used to the weight. Talking about the build quality is top notch. The body is entirely made of aluminum alloy and definitely looks like a premium product, guys. It's got this nice red accent over here which gives it a premium look and has a bevel design. You see this slant angled position over here? This is called the bevel design. So what's the benefit of this is, so whenever you're shooting videos with your camera, this arm doesn't interfere or obstruct your view, guys. So you can clearly see what you're shooting on the camera screen. So that is one huge advantage on this gimbal. And okay, so it's got these three balancing arms, pan, tilt and roll. So you've got these thumb screws over here using which you can balance the gimbal. And over here you've got the complete control panel. There's a full touch screen on it, guys. This is a touch screen. You can easily navigate the menu, adjust all the camera options, gimbal settings using just your finger. It also has a special magic ring. It's a multi-function magic ring and offers a lot of functions which we'll talk about later in the video. Below that, you've got a four-way navigational joystick and some more buttons over here. I'll give you a complete detailed look at all the menu and buttons in the next clip. And going down over here, guys, you see I've already attached a tripod. It's an aluminum tripod as we've seen in the unboxing. So using this, you can just expand it, place the gimbal wherever you want. And not only that, we also got that carbon fiber attachment rod in the box, right? You can attach that and get a great grip on the gimbal. It's very useful. It's also super lightweight. It won't increase the weight of the gimbal that much and can be super helpful while shooting videos with the gimbal. Right now, I'm not attached that, but I'll show that once we get started with the modes of the gimbal. Talking about the comfort now, the gimbal has this nice rubberized finish over here. So whenever you hold your hand like this, it offers you a nice comfortable experience and gives you a great grip over the gimbal. So that was about the comfort part. Now along with the control panel on the front side, you also have some more buttons over here on the side as well as a quick shortcut button at the back side. And along with that, you even have two quarter inch threads, one over here and also one on the bottom side. So you can attach some extra attachments like a tripod, a microphone over here or some sort of LED light and things like that. Okay, let me power on the gimbal and show you. To power it on, you just need to press this power button over here for about 2 to 3 seconds. And there you go. Our gimbal is on and all ready to be used. And this is how the display on it looks like. It's got a beautiful touch display, guys. So what I'll do is I'll just give you a closer look at the display, show you all of its menu features and what are all these buttons. So let's get started. So this is how the smart touch panel on the FiuTex AK4000 gimbal looks like. It's a very nice LCD display, guys. It's bright, sharp, and all the text is easily readable even in bright outdoor conditions. Plus it's a touch screen, right? So you can easily navigate through the menu with just your finger. It's quite responsive and works well. So this is a home screen. On the home screen, you've got a lot of quick access shortcuts, like you've got Wi-Fi, Bluetooth. This is the battery level indicator of the gimbal. And this is a gimbal modes. So by just tapping on that, you can change between different modes. It's got four different modes. I'll talk about that at a later part in the video after this. This is a camera control shortcut. So you can control the camera using the gimbal itself. And this is a zoom control. You can just use this magic wheel to control the zoom. And this is a gimbal control. Using this, you can switch between different axes of the gimbal and control them using this magic arm. So that was about the all the shortcuts on the home screen. By swiping right on the home screen, you can access all the camera control options. From here, you can check out the exposure value, you can adjust the ISO and all such camera controls. Going one more step over here, you've got the white balance settings. It's got a lot of white balance options like auto white balance, daylight, and all that, guys. You can adjust the white balance from over here. So that's it, there's nothing else on the left. And going to the right side, you've got the gimbal settings. This is called the payload setting. Over here, you can adjust the payload automatically or you can even set your own preset. I would definitely leave it to automatic because the gimbal itself will adjust the payload settings depending on the weight of the camera. Along with that, you've got capture mode. You've got three options over here, which is default, smooth and action. It's right now in smooth, but if you want some quick action cinematic shots, you can switch it to action mode. Then time-lapse mode, so you can set all the rotation times and all that, and gimbal will automatically shoot the required time-lapse. Along with that, you've got some scroll settings, gimbal settings, which includes calibration and language settings. That's it. So these are all the options and menu on the AK4000 gimbal. Below that, you've got this four-way navigational joystick. Using this, you can completely control the gimbal, and the display also shows you which direction you're controlling the gimbal. You see those lines? That is pretty cool, right? The quality of the joystick is very nice. It's smooth and controls the gimbal precisely. Beside that, on the right, you've got a power button. This is the video record button. On the left, you've got the camera shutter button. And above that, you've got the mode button. This is a magic wheel, guys, a multifunction magic wheel. Using this, you can do a lot of things like control the follow focus or control the zoom of the camera, and also the control the gimbal movements. I'll show you all of those features after this clip. And at the backside, you've got this quick access shortcut, guys. It offers a lot of multifunctions, like by double clicking it, you can instantly reset the gimbal to its original position. So that was our detailed look at the display, all the buttons available on it, and also the magic wheel. So what I'll do is I'll just go out, show you all the different available modes on this gimbal and see how the gimbal performs. Alright guys, so we're here on my terrace, and as you can see, the gimbal is perfectly balanced. Plus, I've also attached the carbon fiber extension rod for extra support. The gimbal feels quite comfortable and offers a great grip while handling. Now let's talk about the different modes available on this gimbal. The AK4000 has 4 modes on it, and by default, whenever you power it on, you'll enter into the pan follow mode. In the pan follow mode, the gimbal will follow your movements in the pan axis direction, while the tilt and the roll axis are locked. Just check out this clip. So that is how the pan follow mode works. But don't worry guys, you can still use the navigational joystick to control the gimbal movements in the tilt axis range. Going to the next mode, this one's called the follow mode. In the follow mode, the gimbal follows your movements in the pan axis as well as the tilt axis direction, while the roll axis is locked. This is one of my favorite modes and I use it most of the time. The gimbal movements are very nice and feel buttery smooth while using. So next on the list is full follow mode. In this mode, the gimbal swiftly follows your hand movements in all the directions, including the roll axis. Using this mode, you can shoot some amazing and creative cinematic shots. And finally, this is the last gimbal mode. It's called the lock mode. Now this is a very interesting mode because the gimbal is locked in a particular position and doesn't change no matter what you do. That is so cool, right? Now let me tell you about the special features of this magic ring. The magic ring on it can be used for a lot of things, like you can control the gimbal movement swiftly in all the directions. It works so well and the ring is also very smooth. It felt as if there was zero friction while using it. You can use it for taking some amazing shots which are not possible using bare hands. So like this, you can control it in tilt axis, pan axis, as well as roll axis. Amazing, right? I love these features. And not only that, you can even use it to control the follow focus and also your camera zoom. And finally, by double clicking the button at the back, the gimbal will return to its original default position. Now let me also fix the dual handle grips to the gimbal and show you. So using those dual handle grips will completely transform your AK4000 into an ultimate cinematic shooting rig. This thing is like crazy awesome, guys. It's very comfortable to hold the gimbal and shoot videos in this way. The dual handle grip evenly distributes the weight and reduces the strain on your hand. And since it's made of carbon fiber, the cage is super strong yet very lightweight. And guys, you know what? For some reason, whenever you hold these dual handle grips, it gives the same feel as if you're holding a car steering wheel. I really love this accessory. Okay, now let me show you some sample footages that I shot with this gimbal and tell you about its performance. Alright guys, we'll be doing two types of tests to see how this gimbal performs. In this first video clip, we'll be doing a normal walk test where I'll hold the gimbal in my hand and shoot videos. So let's see how it performs. Holy moly, just look at that video! It looks so smooth! The video looks as if the camera was gliding in the air. The gimbal was doing a very good job in stabilizing the video. I was quite impressed by the results. So that was our gimbal test while walking. Now let's step up the game. This time, instead of walking, I'll be running with the gimbal and see how it performs. The video was greatly stabilized and the gimbal was giving excellent stabilized shots no matter how hard you push it, all thanks to its powerful M4 kernel motor control units and high precision software algorithms. Even though I was running, there was no sort of shake in the video, except while twisting the angle at extreme position at the corners. The AK4000 combined with the dual handle grips produces ultimate cinematic shots. It feels very comfortable while shooting and gives buttery smooth stabilized footage. I had a great experience shooting with the gimbal. The AK4000 has a pan axis range of 360 degrees as well as 360 degrees roll axis range, but has a tilt axis range of only 230 degrees. The payload it can take is from 150 grams to 4 kgs. But let me show you my experience with the AK4000. I've used a variety of cameras on this gimbal, and what I've seen was the gimbal was performing very well with heavy loads. For example, with cameras like Canon C200, C300, 1DX Mark II, 5D or Sony A7 III, it was giving excellent results. Even with my Sony A6500 combined with a heavy zoom lens, I faced no sort of problems. But when I use some basic lightweight mirrorless cameras or DSLRs like my Panasonic G7 or G9 or Sony A6300 combined with its kit lens, the gimbal's motors were vibrating in certain positions. That means that this gimbal is not made for beginners with simple cameras. The AK4000 is a professional gimbal made for pro cinematographers with expensive cameras and heavy lenses. So that is one thing you should keep in mind. Okay, let me tell you about the battery life. The battery life was very good on this gimbal. It runs on 4 18650 batteries and offers a continuous working time of about 11 to 12 hours. And charging the batteries fully with the provided charger took around 5 to 6 hours. Well, that was my review on FiuTech's AK4000 flagship 3-axis gimbal for DSLRs. It's an amazing gimbal and offers excellent stabilized shots. Offers a smart touch panel which is both convenient as well as useful. Has a special multi-function magic ring and offers a monstrous load capacity of up to 4 kgs. I was quite satisfied with the results. The only thing I'd say is this product is made for professionals with premium grade camera equipment. It's not suitable for beginners or lightweight cameras. The FiuTech's AK4000 gimbal costs around 36,000 rupees and the carbon fiber dual handle rig costs 12,000 rupees. You need to buy that separately. I'll leave links to both of them in the description box below. You can check it out there. So that was it for today. Hope you all enjoyed the video. Make sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more new awesome videos. And I'll see you in the next one.